Ano po yung, kahit hindi po sagutin ngayon, sa inyong summation na lamang po para hindi maubos yung oras natin, natanong ko na rin po ito dati, 3 out of 6 out of 8 po, pinunuan. Hindi natin pwedeng sabihin nagsinungaling na tinayuan niya yung fair market value, iniwang blanco kasi yung acquisition cost eh. Ngayon, kung ang iniwan niyang blanco ay yung acquisition cost, paglabag ba yun? Pakibigay po sa amin yung argumento at basihan sa inyong mga summation pagdating po ng panahon.
Okay.
Hindi na po ngayon. Ayoko pong pasukan yan ngayon para makapagbato rin ng presentasyon ng ebidensya.
We'll be dealing with it when we file our memorandum.
At paki-address na rin po, ano po ang definition at pagtingin ninyo sa konsepto ng substantial compliance at good faith compliance kaugnay po ng iso at bagay na ito para mag-iyahan po kami.
We will file our memorandum as required.
At the proper time.
Yes,
thank you, counsel. Thank you.
Please proceed with the trial.
Yes, Mr. President.
Stop this argument, you know. We are in the period of presentation of evidence.
Yes.
Come on.
Yes, Mr. President. And hopefully, what is transpiring is being monitored by the Civil Service Commission. Because it is their sal-in form that is somehow confusing. Yes, defective and confusing. So hopefully they will listen to the Senate Committee on Civil Service, chaired by Senator Trillanes, so that we can correct all of this. May we recognize Senator Recto very quickly, Mr. President?
The gentleman from Batangas.
Thank you very much, Mr. President. I will no longer belabor the issues on what 202 of the local government code, 203, 204, going back to the issues of current fair market values, schedule of market values, and assessed values as discussed earlier. But first, I'd like to find out from both the defense and the prosecution to guide me. No? What law says that we must put in the SALN assessed value, current fair market value, and acquisition cost?
Ang tingin ko po, walang definite provision sa any law. If I recall correctly, hindi ko po.
So wala kayong alam na batas na nagsasabi na kailangan i-fill up natin lahat ito mga...
Completely and correctly.
Completely and correctly. Ito tatlong values na hinihingi sa SALN.
Kasi po, ang pagkaunawa ko, sa panig po ng depensa, ang pagkaunawa ko po, itong form na ito, binalangkas nila na hindi ugmang-ugma sa pangangailangan o sa mandato ng any specific law.
Whatever it is.
Yes, Your Honor.
The duty is imposed by the Constitution. And all of us, whether lawyer or accountant, know what is the meaning of asset, know what is the meaning of liabilities, and know what is the meaning of net worth.
That is correct, Mr. President.
Ignorantia legis, neminem excusa.
That is correct, Mr. President.
So, let's not belabor this. Let's go back to the
trial
and present the evidence so that we can finish this case.
Yes, precisely, Mr. President. And I will get to that very briefly. Thank you, Mr. President. Second point na gusto kong tanungin, hindi naman dinidispute ng prosecution. Oh, first, meron ba kayong sagot doon sa katanungan ko sa unang katanungan sa prosecution side naman?
Meron po, Your Honor. The sworn statement of assets, liabilities, and net worth is required under Republic Act 6713.
Alam natin yon. Opo. Pero doon nakalagay ba yung assessed value, current fair market, at acquisition cost?
Opo. Doon po sa form, expected po ang declarant na sabihin niya...
Sa batas nakalagay yun doon, na kailangan itong tatlong value ilagay. Para maintindihan ko,
opo.
Nakalagay doon sa batas opo. Yan. I'll take your word for it and I'll read the law. Thank you. Okay. No one is disputing here between the prosecution and the defense what the witness has testified on with regard to the assessed value and the current fair market value as in the SALN. Kasi ito galing naman to sa tax declaration na issued ng assessor. So palagay ko walang dispute dito. Huh? Is that correct? For the prosecution side?
No, Your Honor. Because there was selective use of the values
I'm just talking about the assessed and the current fair market value in the SALN.
That is correct, Your Honor. There is selective use. For example, for the house and lot.
I heard your testimony earlier. Okay? But tagig lang to, ha? Tagig. The two condos lang. Okay? Kasi apparently the numbers are the same as what has been testified.
Yes, Your Honor.
Okay? So, ay, palagay ko walang dispute dito eh. Ha? Galing to sa tax declaration mismo eh. Okay? Maliwanag tayo dyan. Ha? Kaya tayo humahaba din, not because only of the senator judges, gawa no, I don't know why the prosecution is belaboring this issue. Okay? Now, the last point, acquisition cost. Palagay ko nandito yung malaking problema as far as the prosecution is concerned. Bakit hindi linigay yung sa deed of sale, yung halaga doon? Yun ang ibig sabihin, pati ng Senate President, na lahat tayo naintindihan natin yan sa acquisition cost. Is that correct?
Tama po.
Tama yon.
Tama po.
Ngayon, walang kasagutan naman ng depensa kung bakit hindi linagay. Basta sinabi lang, walang linagay.
Wala pong nakalagay.
Walang nakalagay.
I'm just basing my observation on what
correct. A patient is. So ano ngayon nasasabi ng prosecution? Kung walang linagay, may tinatago. Is that what you're saying?
Opo.
Maliwanag.
Opo. Very obviously.
Obviously.
Opo.
Ha? At kung titignan mo yung SAL mula 92 hanggang sa ngayon,
wala po.
Walang linagay sa acquisition cost.
Tama po yun.
Doon lang sa assess at current fair market value may nakalagay.
Opo.
Tama ho ba yun?
Tama po.
So simula noong 92, sinasabi mo, kahit na irrelevant yung 92, at pag-usapan lang natin 2002 hanggang 2010.
The gentleman from Makati and Bicol.
I've been watching the proceedings. A private prosecutor is arguing on points of law. It has been cleared. And the rule is, as stated by the impeachment court, is that when it comes to points of law, only public prosecutors will argue points of law. The private prosecutors can only examine witnesses. A private prosecutor cannot appear for the House of Representatives. Only a congressman can appear for the House of Representatives. We are now talking about theories and all that. So will you please?
I will yield, Your Honor.
Oh, at para matapos ka, isang minuto na lang. Okay. So, okay. So, ang contention ngayon dito, as far as assets, real properties are concerned, wala pa tayo sa banko eh. Ha? Yung problema ng hindi paglagay ng what is declared in the deed of absolute sale sa acquisition cost. And your contention is that meron tinatago.
That's true, Your Honor. Totoo po yun.
Yun ang sinasabi ninyo. Ha? And palagay ko, kung bakit tatlo ang nakalagay dito, ay dahil, halimbawa, pag-donation yung property, at meron isang donation dito, meron bang acquisition cost yun?
Definitely none.
None?
Because it is gratuitous.
Tama. So wala ka talaga mailalagay sa acquisition cost.
Pero sa donation, the value at which you compute the
tax declaration,
the donor's tax, is the value that must be reflected in your books.
Okay. Tama po yun. Kaya pag donation, kaya hinihingi ng batas, the assessed value for current fair market value, para may basehan sa pagbilang, meron accounting standard na susundan. Ha? So zero sa acquisition cost, may halaga to, may standard ka. Ha? Ngayon, I don't think we can fault the Chief Justice naman on one point. Simula nung nag-umpisa, wala siya linagay sa acquisition cost. I don't think that is correct. But para maging pareho lang, yung accounting standard, ginamit niya yung real property tax declaration. Tignan mo yung data lahat-lahat. Kasi may nag-umpisa siya with a donation, a property. No? So, meron bang batas na nagsasabi sa atin din? Just for my guidance, and I will sit down. No? And kung wala kayong sagot, you can just provide it to the impeachment court.